and then 125. Okay. So what are the factors of 672 then? Factors of 672.
Sir,
2 raised to 5 into 3 into 7. 2 raised to 5 into 3 into 7, right? Okay, how many of you got this one? 2 raised to 5 and into 3 into 7? Okay, so this one is correct then. 120, 2 raised to?
2 raised to 3 into
3
into
5. Into 3 into 5, okay. So, is this correct? All of you got the same, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Next, LCM. How you find LCM? How you find the LCM?
Sir, we should take the greatest power.
Okay, we should take the greatest power. Okay, what was the sentence? Just read out that sentence. Okay, of each prime factor, not common. Okay, not common, of each prime factor. So for that, first start from 2. Okay, so which one is having the highest power here? 2 raised to 5 and 2 raised to 3. So 2 raised to 5. Okay, after 2, we have this 3. Okay. So again, 3 raised to 1 and 3 raised to 1 here. So we can take 3. Okay, after 3, 5. Right? Take 5 and then 7. Right? If there is a single factor here, 5 is a factor of 120. 5 is a factor of 120. But we don't have any factor of 5 here for 672. So in such cases, okay, take just 5 here. And then here also, see here. 7 is a factor of 672, but we don't have any 7 here. Still, you need to take this 7 here. Okay. So, that's why yesterday what I told you is here. If there is no factor, I can take 5 raised to 0 here and then 7 raised to 0. Right. So, 5 raised to 1 and then 5 raised to 0. So, highest factor is 5 raised to 1. So, that's why you need to take 5 here. Similarly, 7 raised to 0 and then 7 raised to 1. So, the highest power is 7 raised to 1. So, 7. Fine. Okay. So, when you multiply these, what you will get?
3360.
3360. Yes or no? Yes, sir. 3360. Okay. If you took 672, 120, then answer is 3360. Okay. If you took 672 and then 120, okay. What are the factors of 6? 2 into 3. Right? What are the factors of 72?
2 cube into 3 square.
2 cube into 3 square. Okay, what about 120? Again?
2 cube into 3 into 5.
3 into 5. Right? So now take the now. Highest common fact, highest power. What is the highest power of 2 here? 2 raised to 3 and then 3 raised to 2. Okay, 5. Okay, so what is the product? 360. Okay, fine. Any doubts? Any doubts in finding the LCM? No?
No, sir.
No, sir. Siddhi? 1.2, third main. 1.2, third main. Okay. How to find HCF? So, we solve this third one. What are the problems we solved in the last class from the second exercise? No. See here. Question number 3. We found the HCF of 3 numbers.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any doubts in third question? How to find HCF of 3 numbers? Okay. So, let me revise this third question again. See here. Question number 3 from the second exercise, third main, first one, okay, 12, 15 and then 21, 12, 15 and 21. Okay, so how to find HCF? How to find, let me take that. Atharva, see 12, 15 and then 21. How to find HCF? Atharva, 12, 15 and then 21. How will you find the HCF of these three numbers? Harshal, how to find the HCF?
Sir, by the prime factorization.
Okay, first factors of 12. What are the factors of 12?
2 into 3.
Okay. Next, what are the factors of 15?
3 into 5.
What are the factors of 21?
3 into 7.
Okay. So HCF, highest common factor, right? Okay. So what is common? What is common out of these factors? 2. So we don't have any 2 here. 3. 3 is common in all the 3. So 3. 5 and 7 are not common. Okay. So here the HCF is 3. So this is how we find HCF of given 3 numbers by finding their factors. Okay. Any other matter? Any other method? So we can use that Euclid's division lemma here. You can find the HCF of these three numbers using Euclid's division lemma. How can you find the HCF of these three numbers using Euclid's division lemma? Anyone? Okay, this is one method, okay, or first method. Okay, second method. Euclid's division lemma. Okay, here this is factorization. Okay, see here. When three numbers are given, okay, to find the HCF, first thing is to get this A and B right. So then only we can use this EDL. What is EDL? Euclid's division lemma. A is equal to BQ plus R. A is equal to BQ plus R. So out of this 12, 15 and 21, okay. So out of this 12, 15 and 21, the greatest number, you should take it as A. That is 21, right? The greatest number out of the given three numbers will be your A. The next number is your B, okay. So first A is equal to 21 and then B is equal to 15. Now substitute these two values here. So what you will get? Or you can do the division. If you divide this 21 by 15, what you will get? 15, 6. Okay. So next. Next. 0. So what is your HCF? As the remainder is 0, the HCF of these two numbers, HCF of 21 and 15 is 3. Right? This is my HCF if these two are the given numbers. So, but we have 3 numbers here. Right? Okay. 3 numbers are given here. So, again, in the next step, okay, this is your first step. In the second step, the third number, okay, just compare these two, whatever the HCF you get here or the divisor you have here in this first step and this third number, that is 12. So which one is greater here? 12 is greater. So take A is equal to 12 and then B is equal to 3. Again, follow the same division, that is 12 divided by 3. Okay, so you will get 0 here. So what is the HCF? 3, right? So this divisor is your HCF. Okay, so generally don't follow this step. If it is mentioned, okay, it may in some questions, okay, they will mention this one: find the HCF of the given numbers using Euclid's division lemma. If the question is find the HCF of the given numbers using Euclid's division lemma, then you have to follow the second method. If it is not given, then whichever you are comfortable, either using multiples or factorization or PDF. Fine. Make a note, the second method. HCF final ho gaya barku bari idana ta alli din book anta bari idana 12 15 21
ee mishada
idana maarti ha idana yen illa 12 da factors kotla antidu anta hele long division maadkonta hoguda idrudu factors tegida idrudu factors tegida HCF find maadbekandra mooru dara yav common ide
common idu
ha astu
ee madalinu gain chokandi yen kalasirala
Okay, so now find the HCF of 8, 9 and 25 by this EDL. Find HCF of 8, 9 and 25. Okay, let me write it here. 8, 9 and then 25. Find HCF of 8, 9, 25 using EDL. Okay, solve and show me this one. EDL. 8, 9 and 25. B is equal to 9. Next,
we have to divide
25 by 9. 9 2s are 18. You will get 7 here. Again, 9 and 7. 7 ones are 7. 2. So, we will get 1 and then again divided by 1. So, you got 1 here, right? Now, take this 1 will be your B and the remaining number. The third number A is equal to 8 and then B is equal to 1. Okay. So, now we divide 8 by 1. 1 8 is 8, 0. So, this is my HCF. Okay. 1 is the HCF. Right, Prajwal, le Prajwal kotha eta? Okay, fine. So we will move to the next problem. That is question number 5. Any doubts till question number 5? First 4 problems, any doubts?
No, sir.
No, right?
No, sir.
Okay. Then question number 5. So the question number 5 is check whether second exercise, question number 5. Check whether 6 raised to n. Check whether 6 raised to n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. Okay, I will read it again. Listen carefully. Check whether 6 raised to n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. Okay, understood the question? Read the question again. Check whether 6 raised to n, check whether 6 raised to n can end with, can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. Okay, so we need to check. Okay, what is this n here? N is natural number. Okay, so n is a natural number starting from 1. So see, okay, okay, before this, okay, if you have 5 in the base, okay, if you have this 5 in the base, okay, if I take 5 raised to 1, how much will you get here? 5, 5 raised to 2, 25, 5 raised to 3, 125, right, 5 raised to 4, 5 raised to 4? 125 into 5 is? 125 into 5 is 625. Yes or no? 5 raised to 4 is 625, right? Yes or no? See, 5 raised to 4 can be written as 25 into 25, right? 5 raised to 2 into 5 raised to 2. What is 5 raised to 2? 25. 25. What is 25 square? 625. Okay. See here. So what do you observe here? So always if the base is 5, if the base is 5, okay, so in the unit digit, okay, in the unit you will get always 5. Take any number, 5 raised to 10, 5 raised to 24, whatever the number, whatever may be the power. Okay. So if it is 5 raised to n, if it is in the 5 raised to n form, if the given number is 5 raised to n form, then the unit digit is always 5. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts? Yes. No. So if the given number is 5 raised to n, okay, this is not related to your question. Okay. So I will come to this question. Before that, so 5 raised to n, if the base, this one is called base and this one is called power, right? So this is my power and this is my base. If the base is 5 and power any natural number, power can be any natural number, then definitely you will get 5 in the unit digit, right? Okay, fine. So if the given number is 10, 10 raised to 1, 10, 100 raised to 1, 10 raised to 2, not 100 raised to 1, let me keep the base same, I will keep base same, 10 raised to 2, then you will get 100, 10 raised to 3, you will get 1000, okay, keep some. Okay, again, if the given number is in this form, 10 raised to n form, if the given number is in the form of 10 raised to n, so definitely you will have 0 in the unit digit, right? Okay, this one you know, right? So third one is important, okay? So what I will do, I will take a number, okay? I will take some number here, so where 2 and 5 are the factors. Okay, give me some number where 2 and 5 are the factor. 20. Okay, 50. Or take 20. Let me take 20. Okay. So, 20 raised to 1. Let me write it as 20 raised to 1. Okay, 20 can be written as? Huh. 5. 2 into 2 into 5. Let me keep just frame factors, okay? 20 can be written as 2 into 2 into 5 raised to 1, okay? So what I will do, I will take the same number, 20. Let me take same 20 and then I will take 2 here, okay? So 2 into 2 into 5 whole raised to 2. So here you will get 20 and here, how much you will get here? What is 20 square? 400. Okay, what about 20 cube? Again, factors will remain same, right? Base is same. 2 into 2 into 5 whole raised to 3. Huh?
Sir,
8,000. 8 3 zeros. Right? Okay. So again here the unit digit is 0. Right? So what you need to observe here is if the factors of the base, okay, this is my base. If the factors of the base is having this 2 and 5. If the factors of the base are having 2 and 5, then definitely the number will end with a 0. Okay, take any number, okay? You can take some random number, huh? Okay, where 2 and 5 are the factors? 2 and 5. So keep some other number here. Let me take 3. Okay. So product, what you will get here? 30. Okay. So any other number? So if you here 30 raised to any number, 30 raised to anything will give 0 in the unit digit. Yes or no? Am I confusing? Confuse ho rahega? Nahi na? No, right? You will get 0 in the unit digit only if these two are the factors. Try to understand. Okay, take any number. If the number is having 2 and 5, if the number is having 2 and 5 in their factors, if the number is having 2 and 5, both the just 2. It should have both the 2 and 5. If it is having 2 and 5, then definitely the number will end with 0 in the unit digit. Fine. If the number is not having 2 and 5, no chance. Okay. It won't have 0 in the unit digit. You can take any random number and check. Okay. So now back to question. Okay. So what is your question here? Okay, so do one thing. Okay, before this, make a note. Copy this one. Copy all this right hand side. Jo bhi hai na, right hand side. Copy this one. And then after copying this, make a note. Here we note that numbers ending with zero has both two and five as their prime factors. Okay, make a note. बदले इन बड़ी इधर जाप तो मुझे तो डरी इन आर एक्सरसाइज लेट मी नो वंस यू कॉपी दिस CBSE is your first chapter. Vaishnavi, वैष्णवी वैष्णवी अंडरस्टूड ओके इफ द नंबर एंड्स विद अ जीरो देन इट शुड हैव फैक्टर्स टू एंड फाइव ओके टू एंड फाइव मस्ट बी द फैक्टर्स ऑफ द गिवन नंबर फॉर एग्जाम्पल सी अ नंबर इज इन दिस फॉर्म a raised to n okay a raised to n so n is some natural number a given number is in the form a raised to n n is some natural number so here if I want the unit digit when I expand this one okay it might be a raised to 5 a raised to 6 or a raised to 10 okay so I need 0 in the unit digit okay always I need 0 in the unit digit okay So then what should be my A? Vaishnavi? A should be in which form? Huh? Okay. 2 into 5. 2 into 5. With this 2 into 5, it can have any other number or any other factor. Okay. So you can write it as X into 2 into 5. Okay, x can be any other prime factor or you can take p. Okay, p into 2 into 5. But this 2 into 5 is must. Okay, this 2 into 5 is must raised to n. Okay, then only you will get 0 here. Okay, so if I take p is equal to 1, then you will get 1 into 2 into 5, that is 10, 10 raised to n. Okay, so definitely you will have 0 in the unit digit. If I take p is equal to 2, then how much you will get here? 20 raised to n. Again, there is a 0 in the unit digit. Okay, n can be any number. It can be 10, 20, 30. Take any number, any natural number. Always, the expanded form, okay, will end with 0. Okay, so back to question. Okay, so here in this given question, whereas 6 raised to n. Okay, so what is 6? What are the factors of 6? 2 into 3 whole raised to n. 2 into 3 whole raised to n. Okay. So, what are the factors of 6? 2 into 3. So, is there 5 here? 5 is missing, right? 5 is missing from the factors of 6. So, does this end with 0? No. As 6 raised to n does not have 5 as a prime factor. Okay, it does not have 5 as a prime factor. So it does not end with 0. So it does not end with 0. Again, one more important question. Okay, mark this question, question number 5. You may get this one for 3 marks. Okay, it does not end with 0. Therefore, 6 raised to n cannot end with 0 for any natural number n. Okay, you can take any natural number n, so it won't end with 0. Right? Okay, so then try this one. Follow the same steps. 4 raised to n. Okay, next question 4 raised to n. check whether 4 raised to n can end with the digit 0. Check whether 4 raised to n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number. Okay, for any natural number. So, you'll understand either?
Sir,
huh.
Sir, should we give those examples also?
No. Okay, these examples are not required. Okay, just this, whenever you get this question, okay, you need to write this.
Okay, sir.
Okay, this is enough. All this is not required. Okay. Prajwal understood? Okay. Kerala. Neeta Kerala. Inno chala. Huh? Iga. N ide number. 6 raised to N ide. N kodi thara. 6 raised to N. How the? So, first N maadu bokotho. E sentence. N ide nodi le. Here we note that number ending with 0. Here we note that number ending with 0 has both 2 and 5 as their prime factors. And then gotha ega ether expansion. Okay, either need solve madidaga illing 0 bake. How the either solve madidaga illing 0 bake andra is 6 irath gotha 6th factors olaga either do irbakil 2 and 5 6th factors olagidra asta other unit digit olagin irathi 0 irath. How the okay, but in 6th factors any dava. ಫೈವ್ ಐತ್ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಫೈವ್ ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫೈವ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಇದ್ರದ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಫೈವ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಜೀರೋ ಓಕೆ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಇದೆ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಅದು ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಲ್ಲ ರಿಯಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಇದಾವೆ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಭಾಳ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಇದೆ ಹಾಂ ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಡ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಲೆಮ್ಮಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿದೆ ಹೇಳಿ ನೋಡೋಣ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ನಾವಲ್ಲೇ ಓಕೆ ಏನು ತೊಗೋತೀವಿ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂತ ತೊಗೋತೀವಿ ಹಾಂ ಸೊ ಅದು ನೀವೇನು ಸೆವೆಂತ್ ಏಯ್ತಲ್ಲಿಂದನೂ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಸೆವೆಂತ್ ಏನು ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಿ ನೀವು ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡಿಂದ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಹೌದಾ ಆದರೆ ಏನು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅದನ್ನು ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಲೆಮ್ಮಾದಿಂದ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಇದೆ ನೋಡು 6 ರೇಸ್ ಟು n ಅಂತ ಐತಿ ಓಕೆ ನೀ ಏನು ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಹೇಳು ಈ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋ ನಂಬರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ 2 and 5 ಐತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಓಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಬೌತ್ 2 and 5 ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಬೌತ್ 2 and 5 ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಹಾಂ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ 0 ಇಫ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ 2 and 5 ಆಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ 0 ಇಫ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಎಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ 0 ಓಕೆ ಫೈನ್ ಓಕೆ ನಾವು ಟ್ರೈ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ 4 raised to n ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಹಾಂ ಹಾಂ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಐ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಯುವರ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ರೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಶ್ರಾವಣಿ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ನೋಡು ಓಕೆ ಶೇಮ್ ಇದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ 4 raised to n ಓಕೆ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಚೆಕ್ ಓಕೆ Okay. So next question number 6. Any doubts here? Shravani? Shravani, you know what is there? Now you are audible. No need to substitute any value. Okay, if see here. You need to check whether this 4 is having this 2 and 5 as its factor. Okay. So if you want, you can just put some value and then check. Okay. But it's not wrong. Okay. So after this or in between, you can substitute some value for this n. Okay. So you won't get 0. Right? But instead of substituting any there are infinite numbers of natural number. Infinite natural number. So which one you will take? As an example, you can take any two numbers. But this is must. Okay, you need to write all this. Okay, with this you can add some examples. Not an issue. Okay, question number 6. Just read it once. Question number 6. Explain why 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13 and 7 plus 6, 7 into 6 into 5 into 4. Okay, shall I erase this one? So here again, question number 6 is important. Okay. From this exercise, first 3 though simple. First 4 questions. Okay, just HCFI and LCM. So after this 4, 5, 6, and 7 are different. Okay. So question number 6. Explain why are composite numbers. Okay, so here two numbers are given. See, here one is 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13. Okay, and one more 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5. What we need to prove here? You understood the question. Okay. So you are given two numbers here and the numbers are in expanded form. So you need to show that here, the given two numbers are composite. Understood the question? First try to understand. Read it again. You are given two numbers, okay, and both the numbers are in expanded form. Okay, if I instead of these two numbers, if I give some 25 and then 37, okay, if I give you 25 and 37, are these two composite numbers? Are these two composite numbers? 25 is a composite number, yes or no? Is 25 composite number? Is 25 a composite number?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Deepa, what is a composite number? What is a composite number? It should have more than two factors, you can say, okay? Composite number, it should have more than two factors, right? Okay, what is prime number? If a given number is divisible by 1 and itself, if given number is divisible by 1 and itself, then it is called a prime number, then it is called a prime number. If a number is divisible by 1 itself and then one more number, or you can say if a number is having more than 2 factors, then it is composite. So what are the factors of 25? 1, 25 and 5, right? So here we have 3 factors. So 25 is a composite number. Okay, what about 37? 1, 37, any other factor? Is it divisible by any other number?
No, sir.
No, right? Okay. So 37 is not divisible by any other number. So 37 is a prime number. 25 is a composite number. So this is how we prove given number is composite or prime. So but here in question number 6, instead of a number, you are given some expanded form. So how to find the number out of this? Okay, don't solve it completely. Okay, no need to solve it completely and then get a number. So instead of that, so what I will do, okay, so this is my first term and this is my second term because we have this plus sign here. So what I will do, I will take this whole as one term and this one as other term. So what is common in these two? What is common in these two? 13 is common, yes or no? 13 is common, so I will take 13 outside. So if I take 13 outside, then I will be left with 7 into 11 plus 1. Any doubts in this step? 7 into 11 plus 1. No? Okay, keep 13 as it is. So 7 into 11 is 77 plus 1. 13 into 78. Just like here, if I correlate this one with some algebraic function, so what I will do, a, b, x plus x, a, b, x plus x, okay, so here x is my 13, if you compare these two, so what is common here, x is common, then you will get a, b plus 1, right, okay, this is same as that. So here I am taking x as common, similarly here I will take 13 as common. So instead, because here multiplying and then addition, that will take time. Okay, you need to multiply all the three numbers and then add. So instead of that, what I will do, I will take this 13, I will take 13 outside, then you will get this 13 into 78. Okay, so is this a prime number, 13 into 78? Not just 13, 13 into 78. It can't be right, it can't be a prime number because it is a product of two numbers. Okay, see you. So what is the product of 13 and 78? What is the product of 13 and 78? Check. 1014. 1014. Right? So is 1014? Is 1014 a prime or composite? Obviously, it is a composite number because we have this 4 in the unit digit, so definitely it is divisible by 2. So instead, we can reduce one step here. Don't multiply these two numbers. Okay, your multiplication of these two numbers is not required because already this number is a product of 13 and 72. What is the meaning of that? The product of this number is divisible by 13 and 72. The product of this number is divisible by 13 and 78. So it can't be a prime number. Yes or no? You are getting my point, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So instead of finding that, what was that value? 1018. 1014. Okay. Here. You can find this 1014 here itself. Okay. Multiply all the three numbers and add 13. You will get 1014. Right, so but here whenever you get this question in the exam, you need to use the factorization method. Okay, you need to show that the given number is composite by their factors. Okay, don't multiply it and then add and then get this number. Okay, as the given number is divisible by 2, it is not a prime number. Okay, that is not the procedure how you solve this one. Okay, so first simplify this, get the factor of the number. Since it has okay, since it has more than two factors, okay. What are those factors? 13, 78, 1, okay. Or see here, if you want, you can add one more step here. So 13 is a prime number. 13 into 78. 78 can be written as, so if you factorize 78, what you will get? Okay, 2 into 3 into 13. So this number, whatever the product you will get, is having these many factors. Okay, so since it has more than two factors, that is 13, 2, 3, and then 13. Okay, it is, since it has more than two factors, it is a composite number. It is a composite number. Fine. Understood or any doubts? Naina. Okay. Now follow the same steps for this one. So first, this is my first number and this is the second number. Take common out of these two. 5 is common. If you take common outside, then you will be left with 7 into 6 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay. Plus 1. Okay. 5. And if you multiply these numbers, then you will get 1008 plus 1. 5 into 1009. 5 into 1009. Okay. So again, two numbers. So actually 1009 is a prime number. It won't have any factors, or even no need to find the factors of this number. You can stop here itself. Because it has more than two factors. What are those? 5, 1009 into 1. Okay, just this one is enough to prove that it is a composite number. Okay, 5, this and this. There are three factors here. Hence, the given number is a composite number. Any doubts? Make a note fast. HCF. Now, Purvi, LCM, HCF. LCM find mode work. Okay. First, CM. Dekho question kya hai? There is a circular path around a sports field. Okay. There is a circular path around a sports field. Sonia takes 18 minutes. Okay. Let me write it here. Time taken by Sonia to drive one round. Okay. How much? 18 minutes. Okay. Next one. Time taken by Ravi. 12 minutes. Okay. So this is the given data. There is a circular path around a sports field. Sonia takes 18 minutes to drive one round, while Ravi takes 12 minutes. Suppose they both start at the same time or the same point. Okay. Suppose they both start at the same point and same time and go in the same direction. So after how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? Okay. So they will start from this point. Okay. Both Sonia and then Ravi, they will start from this point and then they will run in the same direction. Okay. Both are running in the same direction. So here the question is, after how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? Okay. So So here this is, she will take 18 minutes and then he will take 12 minutes to complete one round. Okay, at the end of the round, at the end of one round, okay, so here actually who is faster here, who is running, whose speed is more, Sonia and Ravi, who is running faster?
Ravi,
right? Obviously, because he is covering one round in 12 minutes, just 12 minutes. But Sonia is taking 18 minutes. When Ravi completes one round, Sonia will be somewhere here, behind Ravi, right? And they leave this point, okay? So, as Ravi is faster than Sonia, okay, he will be ahead of Sonia, okay? At all the points. Ravi will be ahead of Sonia at all the points, right? When he completes one round, Sonia will be lagging behind. Okay. Then what is the question here? After how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? Is it possible?
Sure, no.
No. I mean, like, just not one round. They may run for 2, 3, 4. Okay, more than one round. If they drive more than one round, is it possible for them? Okay, and their speed is same. Speed is constant. Every round will be covered by Sonia in 18 minutes, and every round covered by Ravi will be in 12 minutes. Think. Okay. So I could have finished this problem in like 2 minutes, okay? 18 and then 12, find the LCM, okay? But try to understand. You may get some different problem. You may not get the same problem. But if you get the different problem, okay, if you know the concept, if you have the clarity over the concept, then you can easily solve whether to find HCF or LCM. So let it take time, okay? Just try to think. Is it possible? Is it possible that Sonia and Ravi will meet at a point after some time? Okay, is it possible to find time taken by both to meet again? The question was, after how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? After how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? No. Gotakila.
Sir, 36 minutes.
I don't want answer, Baba. Ashel Baba. I don't want answer. Okay. So first tell me, if they meet, how is it possible? First you guys said that, sir, no sir, it is not possible. As the speed of Ravi is more than Sonia, you guys said, so it is not possible. Now you are saying 36 minutes. After 36 minutes, they will meet. How is it possible? Anyone? Think, Martinana. Think. How is it possible that they will meet at the starting point after 36 minutes? Anyone can justify this one? Don't say that, sir, finding LCM will give that 36, okay? I don't need that. Okay. Try to explain me. Matlab, in general was okay, sir. Okay, I don't need this real numbers here. Okay, the concept of real numbers is not required. Okay, as a general. Harshan, correct hai, dragger. Okay, very good. Anyone else?
Sir.
Huh? ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನಾನು, ನಾನು ಬೇಡ ಅದು ಎಲ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಎಚ್ ಸಿ ಎಫ್ ಬೇಡ. ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎಲ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಚ್ ಸಿ ಎಫ್ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ? ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎಲ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಎಚ್ ಸಿ ಎಫ್, ವಿತೌಟ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ಸ್, ವಿತೌಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ ಸಿ ಎಮ್. ಓಕೆ ವೆನ್ ರವಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ರೌಂಡ್, ಓಕೆ ವೆನ್ ರವಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ರೌಂಡ್, ಐ ಸೇಡ್ ಸೋನಿಯಾ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಮ್ವೇರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ರವಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ವೆನ್ ರವಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್? ಟೋಟಲ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಕಿತ್ನ ರಹೇಗಾ ಟೂ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್? ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಟೂ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್
24 minutes.
ಓಕೆ 24 minutes, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 24 minutes ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋನಿಯಾ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೇ ಸಮೇರ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 8 years ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಒನ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಶಿ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ 18 minutes. ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ? ಓಕೆ, ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಒನ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಶಿ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ 18 minutes. ಸೊ 24 minutes, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 24 minutes ಸಮೇರ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಅಗೇನ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ರವಿ, ಸಮೇರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಓಕೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರವಿ. ಓಕೆ ತ್ರೀ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ತ್ರೀ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ ಹಾಂ ತ್ರೀ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ರವಿ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಿಂಗ್ ರವಿ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ರವಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ರೌಂಡ್, ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್? 36 minutes. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಸೋನಿಯಾ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 36 minutes ಫೇರ್ ಸೋನಿಯಾ, ದ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋನಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಹಾ ಅಗೇನ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ರೌಂಡ್ 18 minutes, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ರೌಂಡ್ 36 minutes. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ರವಿ ಡ್ರೈವ್ ಟೂ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ ವೆನ್ ರವಿ ಡ್ರೈವ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ ಸೋನಿಯಾ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್, ಹಾಂ ಸಾರಿ, ವೆನ್ ರವಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಸೋನಿಯಾ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಟೂ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್. ವೆನ್ ರವಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಓಕೆ ಬಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಅಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಸೋನಿಯಾ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸರ್, ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೋನಿಯಾ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೂ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್. ದೇಖೋ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಬೈ ದಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಓಕೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಬೈ ದಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ದ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಓಕೆ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ತು ಸೇಮ್ ಇರೇಗ ನಾ ಉನ್ಕಾ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 36 minutes. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 36 minutes ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ರವಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೋನಿಯಾ ಆಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ? ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್, ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್. ಓಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಇಫ್ ಅಗರ್ ಎ ಸಬ್ ನೈ ಜಾಯೆ ನಾ ತುಮ್ ಲೋಗ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾ ಕರ್ನೆ ಕಾ ಟೈಮ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಬೈ ಬೌತ್ ಟು ಮೀಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ಟೈಮ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಬೈ ಬೌತ್ ಟು ಮೀಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಬೈ ಎಲ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಆಫ್ 18 and 12. Okay, and you know how to find the LCM of 18 and 12, right? Okay, what are the factors of 18? 2 into 3 into 3, yes or no? Or 2 into 3 square, what about the factors of 12? 2 raised to 2 into 3, okay, so LCM is? 2 square into 3, LCM is product of the greatest power of each prime factor. So 2 raised to 2 into 3 raised to 2, which is equal to 2 2s are 4, 9, 9 4s are 36, okay, so 36 minutes. Time taken by both to meet again is 36 minutes. Understood?